if I buy this t-shirt or if I'm browsing for this t-shirt, I may want to actually see this t-shirt, the white one, the white version of the same t-shirt. Or maybe it's just a little bit different. Maybe it's a long sleeve version. In order to do product recommendations correctly inside of Shopify, there's an app, a free app, that you can absolutely do this. So let's find out how to customize your product recommendation. Now, here we have John. He's browsing on our Totally 90s Kid website. He's looking at this hoodie. He really likes it. And he scrolls, keeps scrolling, and then he sees this section right here that a lot of you already have. It's the "you may also like" or product recommendations, or people who purchased this also has purchased X. So at a glance, you can see some random products that just get selected right within here. Now, what if I told you that there's an app, a free app made by Shopify, that you can actually manipulate what products get shown for this particular hoodie right here? Let's find out what app that is. Very simply, we're installing Shopify Search and Discovery. We've talked about this app on multiple videos. I think even the latest video that we recorded. And that's because this app has three main components: the search, it has the filters, and then it has the product recommendations. A lot of people don't know about the product recommendations portion of it. But again, like I said, it allows you to customize those recommended products right there at the bottom, depending on whatever product you want. So we have this already installed in our store. So also wanted to show you here, if we go to our product page, if you don't have the "you may also like" here on the Dawn theme, it's called product recommendations. And as you can see, it gives you, again, it gives you dynamic recommendations. So, but again, they don't really tell you like what those parameters are, but right within here, you can actually manipulate this in terms of how it looks. So depending on, you know, size, how many products you want to showcase, et cetera, adjusting the product cart, mobile layout, and then spacing. So you can do all those things on how to manipulate it. Right within here, we're just under the default product, and it's called product recommendation. Right within here, you cannot do anything. So that's why we need to install that app that just has the functionality to do that. So if we go over here and we go to apps, click on search and discovery, the app does give you some search performance and recommendations performance. So this information is actually going to be very, very beneficial. This store that we have right now, we have pulled up, probably doesn't have enough data to kind of give us some good information, but I would highly suggest to look into this. I also have it, I think I have it open here. So if you go to your analytics and your reports and you categorize your reports by behavior, you will also see some of those same reportings, even a few more expanded ones. So you actually get to know, you know, when people purchase this, they also purchase that. So Shopify is going to give you some of that data. And obviously you're going to know your customers, but the data is also going to be able to let you know what product recommendations are actually working and which ones are not. Now, if we scroll down in here, we'll see recommendations. So we can click on that. So let's find the one that we had pulled up here. So this is the hoodie. So, and then let's search for the hoodie. We're going to click on that. As you can see here, we have our product, and then you can edit the complementary products right within here. And then we also have that same list that shows right here. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. We can see it right here in order, and it tells you that these are auto-generated from whatever reasoning, right, Shopify uses to auto-generate. I would want to say that it's the auto-generated has to do with the types of products that other customers are adding to cart, when they add that to cart, which products they're actually purchasing together, et cetera, or which products they're browsing at the same time. I would think that that would be, you know, the main thing, but sometimes you even want to create something that it's more of a complete the look almost, right? And you can do that by just manipulating these right here. All right, so now that we clicked on the hoodie, you got two options here. You can either add complementary products. So these are gonna be more of that shop the look type product recommendations. And I'll show you exactly where we can add this. But the related products is that one section that we were just talking about. And as you can see right here, this is auto-generated. Hopefully, I'm thinking that the auto-generated has to do with real data based on what customers are adding to the cart, what products maybe they're browsing together. But what we can do here, if we want more granular selection of these, you can do hide all the auto-generated recommended ones so you actually don't see them. You can also just browse for Maybe we have these two that we want to make sure that we showcase, and those two will showcase right here towards the top. You can always manipulate the order of the ones that you actually select. And if you just want to make sure that these two always get, you know, shown on your products, then you can actually add them individually to all your products. And then after that, it's going to go into the auto-generated one. So if we click save on that, as you can see, complimentary, we're not going to touch that right now, but related products, we have those two right there. So if we go back to our product page, let's go ahead and refresh that. And as you can see, that you may also like section, now it has those two products. And then after that, it goes back to the auto-generated one. So through time, these two may change because they're automatically generated, but these two right here are gonna stay static because we handpicked those. Another thing that you can do with product recommendations is that one section. Typically, you see that section right within here, within the what we call the product information block, where we can add more of that complete the look type products, right? So how we do that is just very simply the same way that we just did that. So right within here, within the product recommendations, you find your product, you click on it, and then you wanna add the complementary products. So in here, let's say that this one and this one, these two t-shirts sort of complete the look. We can add those in there and then click save. And then we have them in there. Now, what we have to do over here, let me go ahead and change this to hoodie. What we wanna do here is right inside of your product information block, we can add a block right within here. And then depending on the Dawn theme version that you have, we're using the latest version right now, which is the 7.0.1. If we add a block, you want to see and add the complementary products block. Let's go ahead and click on that. Right within here, we can actually manipulate a little bit of this. I would definitely want to enable quick buy buttons for that. Let's go ahead and save just to see how this looks right now. So let's go back over here, refresh this page. Okay, so at a glance, you can see it pairs well with, and we have both of the products. We can right from within here, choose the options and add to cart. That is pretty sweet, if you ask me. So that's a really, really good way to, again, upsell and cross sell right here within the product page. So you have more of these pairs well with or shop the look version of it. And then you also have that you may also like version right here towards the bottom. Both of them you can actually manipulate through using the search and discovery app. If you like this video and you want to learn more, please subscribe. If you don't want to subscribe and you want hands-on work, we have a website VIP day process right now where we start and finish your Shopify website in one day. We talk about all these best practices. We build your store using those best practices, using the latest and greatest apps, and we do it all within one day. So if you're interested in something like that, make sure to check the link in the description below. Thank you. We'll see you on the next one. Bye.